Hey guys, what's up? How's it going? This is Kazi from cleverprogrammer.com. The question is, how to not get frustrated when stuck coding, okay? So this is either when you're stuck in a coding problem or you're stuck in a coding project. So that's what we're gonna cover in this video. Let's jump right into it. Okay, so a lot of people, you know what happens is that they'll be coding or doing a problem or doing a project and then they get stuck. And it's like, how do you get out of that? And that happens to developers at high advanced levels, to complete beginners who just blank out and have that like brain freeze, brain fart, whatever you wanna say. And basically what we wanna be doing in this video is kind of overcoming, you know, I'm gonna give you tools that you can use so I make sure that that never happens to you again, or at least that you have systems that help you effectively and systematically get through it, okay? So here are a few things that I try to do when I'm stuck in a coding problem. So let's say like I'm on hackerrank.com or Project Euler, or I'm working on a coding project for a company, right? I'm building something. One of the things that I like to do often is when I'm doing something and I'm really stuck in it, what I'll do is I'll leave looking at my text editor. I'll stop trying to just type code in, because when you're trying to do that, that's one of the recipes for disaster. That's when your brain can go blank, okay? So what I recommend when that happens is take out a pen or a pencil and paper, okay? And then just use that. That's a lot better. And the reason for that is because you're gonna be very clear-minded. You're not gonna be worrying about typing. You're not gonna be looking at your text editor, and you're not just trying to type code, okay? And with pen, pencil, and paper, you can just kind of brainstorm and just shoot shit, just whatever ideas that you have, okay? So you can draw things, you can write things in whatever way you want. And a lot of the times what I find is that helps me kind of loosen up my brain muscles, and it lets me see the problem in a different way. So there are two ways of thinking. There's the highly concentrated way of thinking. That's when you're very like narrowed, focused on one specific task. And then there's diffused thinking, okay? This is the type of thinking where when you're stuck and you go for that walk and you come back and now you have your solution for the problem, this is called diffused thinking, which is you actually don't try to narrow down and look for a solution within that narrow little like pathway. What you do instead is you try to broaden your search, okay? Instead of looking like and filtering through specific things in your brain, you broaden that search. So you try to look for any possible solution. At some points, you try not to even let your brain think, okay? And that helps a lot. So if pen and paper and trying to write it down step by step isn't helping, one thing that you get stuck in is you get stuck too deep within a coding problem, okay? So when you're typing up that coding problem and you're solving it, you get stuck too deeply within it, like it gets too literal. So when you try to write it out, write down step by step in English or the language of your choice what is happening. Okay, if you can explain specifically in your language what the problem is about, then you're coming close to understanding the problem and then solving it, okay? Because if you don't understand the problem, you're not going to be able to solve it. So that's why I highly recommend, you know, always trying to do something like have a piece of paper with you, have a, you know, pen with you to write it down. Okay, another thing that I recommend very, very highly when you're stuck in a coding problem is step away from your keyboard. So let's say that you spent 2-3 hours trying to figure this problem out and trying to solve it. And it's happening where you just can't figure it out. You just can't solve it. Go do something completely different for a few hours. All right. Just relax your brain. Don't worry about that problem. If you want to party with your friends, enjoy, have a good time, do that. You want to spend time with your family, do that. You want to go for a bubble tea, do that. Try not to think of the problem. And then when you come back and you're trying to think of the problem, one thing that helps me is I like to pace. So I don't know about you guys, but like when I'll be doing it, I'll just be like pacing like this or like this. Like I just pace a lot back and forth. So this is something that can probably help you, okay? And that's how I think. Even when I'm talking to people, I'll be pacing back and forth. It helps kind of increase the blood flow in your body and to your brain, and that helps you think better. That's how I like to think. So try that, okay? So one, pen and paper, help you, it will help you a lot. Step away from the keyboard. Two, try to translate the problem into your own language, making sure you understand what parameters it's taking. You'll be surprised by how many students I'm working with and they don't understand like what parameters a function is supposed to take when you're trying to write a function or whatever it is, right, that you're working on, or what the client wants to even be the solution. Like the like what the client is looking for is maybe something to do with a better front end, you know, so the user can see this button, like a more beautiful button. And the developer is thinking it's like some complicated back-end database issue, and he's like working on that. So this is that's an extreme example, but a lot of the times, even if you're working on a specific coding problem on HackerRank in your school, in your college, something simple, a lot of the times it's you not understanding the problem. That's why what happens is you hit this wall and you're just stuck. It's because you actually don't understand the problem. So really understand the problem at its very core. You know, exactly what type of thing you're writing, right? Like what type, is it, first of all, when you're writing this function, some simple things like what is this function going to return? What parameter should it be taking? Is it an integer that I'm returning at the end of this function? It, you know, I'm getting very specific here. Is it even a list that I'm returning? Is it a dictionary that this function is returning? Even simple things like that can help you, okay? So that's when you're like stuck in a very specific, you know, technical issue that's going on with what you're working with, right? Now, from a macro level perspective, when your brain is frozen, pen and paper helps, understanding the problem in your language helps, and going for a walk, changing your, you know, changing your perspective of what's going on, like going, you know, getting that bubble tea or whatever it is, that has helped me a ton, okay? So those are some of the ways that I would recommend to you. If you guys have more ways, please put them down in the comments below so other people can see how you study or how you overcome a problem when you're stuck in it. So you can share that with other people and other people can learn from it. And yeah, that's it, okay? So make sure if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, okay? A lot of hard work to make this. If you disliked it, totally fine, give it a thumbs down. I'd rather have you either love me or hate me than just be like lukewarm when you're on this channel, okay? So please take action. I want action takers on this channel. That's what I want to encourage. Subscribe to the channel if you like this video. Hit that bell button so you get all those notifications. As always, thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next video.